Hello to the SG group. Here's my latest meanest update for Ming. Okay, let me show you some of my setup. Here you see the voltage of my charging battery. Currently the battery is not switched to the Bedini SG. I will show you later things. Okay, here's a sample of battery not connected to the SG circuit. I mean the charging battery. Next, here you see the primary battery. Here you see the current voltage of the primary battery. And here you can see the the current in milliamperes which going to run the system. And here you can see the picture of my oscilloscope. I have I think you have not very good view, but I will do my best. You see the voltage of I have 0.5 volts per division on my screen, and you can see this time is per division is 1 millisecond per div. Okay, this is the output of my circuit when charging battery is not connected. Now I try to connect my charging battery. Bear with me, I have one hand. I connect SG circuit to the charging battery. Right, and you see not very good picture because I should stabilize it not a wrong way, like so. No, okay. Take a little bit. It was not scheduled that I will record my video, but for better understanding what I am doing, it should be documented. You can see clearly the spikes. I can increase the view of the spikes, but I have very simple oscilloscope. It's complicated to. Okay, now I have stabilized, and probably you can see at the edges. Not so good, probably so. This sharp points on the screen. You can see that I see that one little bit higher. I mean in this part where I'm pointing right now. There you see some part of the spike, and this is what I get when I connect my circuit with the charging battery. How much milliamperage I currently spend to run the system? It's 85 milliamps to run the system. Now I will point you how much milliamperage I get. 26, it's milliamps, 25 milliamps, and this is the voltage of my charging battery, 11.68. As you can see, I use cardboard parts cutted as a fan. I think it's not so very useful for me, but again, I saw some videos and I adjusted my system too. Okay, this is my circuit. I use MG transistor, which is recommended by Bedini itself, so no problem here on this side. When I disconnect my charging battery, my LED goes on. It's about 200 volts LED. It's very lightened. I switch my additional light off, and you can see it's very good light, 300 volts. My 12 volts or 24 volt system. I think it's very interesting, and I will show you my oscilloscope once again. I can play with this thing a little bit. I don't know how exactly it can help you, but I will try to put this at the highest voltage per division, like 5 volts, and voltage, yes, and you can see now, clearly see this high spike, and I don't think that I take all the spikes which currently produced by my system, but some amount which I can catch it, because it's very clearly sharp, and you can see this this point which I try to show with my finger, this small points where you can clearly see this. And I have one like five spikes which I can catch with my system, and as you can see, it's very fast. What should I can try? I can try, it's currently 5 volts per division and 1 millisecond time division. So I will move time like so. I will try to do, it's a 50 millisecond per division. 20. Voltage always the same, 5 volts per division. 10, then 5, then 2, actually 1, this is the 2. Now 1 millisecond per division, 0.5 millisecond, 0.2 millisecond. Now a little bit adjustment, probably like so, time variable, not so good, level, oh yeah, not so good, okay, probably I should try this one. Yep, like this, and probably this. I just adjusted the time. You have millisecond and things like that, and this, and this, and this, and this. Okay. So clearly, need more. Okay, it's more sharp now. I'm pushing back the time per division. Yep. But this is the same stuff which I think Bedini gets in his system. And it's really charging my battery. Now battery is not switched, connected to the SG circuit. Okay, I will connect my charging battery. Now you see immediately increase in charge. Okay, this is really fun to see this. Now back to my oscilloscope. Once again, you clearly see that something going here. I should make better picture like this one, and I think I can conclude that I have some initial results. I will say that conditioning of the battery is a long process. It about depends on which battery can you have got. Can take a while, but at some point the charge of the battery is increasing, and that's it. Thanks you all, and bye bye.